Time now to bring you all of the sporting action with my colleague Natasha Doraiswamy on All in the Game.
Well, thanks, Evelyn. Here's a hint now. It's cricket coming up on the bulletin. However, it's of the BCCI kind. Wondering what we're talking about? Well, no sweat. It's right here on All in the Game. Well, I doubt the Lalit Modi saga will ever die down forever. It's Lalit Modi versus BCCI. Again, of course, it seems like the former IPL commissioner has fired a salvo at the Indian board, saying that they are trying to block other cricket boards from developing the game of cricket. This is what he had to say in an exclusive interview to NDTV from London.
Right, Mr. Modi, we know that the BCCI has been anti-ICL from the very first day. In fact, all the players who were associated with the ICL were also considered to be taboo as far as the BCCI selecting teams were concerned. But why wait so long to come forward with this piece of information?
Because I have waited for such a long time to come forward with it, only for the reason that, yes, I was part of the BCCI to stop unauthorized cricket, and rightfully so, because the boards would have been impacted at that point in time, and the governing bodies around the world would have been impacted. I've come out now because an official body like the Sri Lankan Cricket Board is now being denied the opportunity to develop cricket in their own country when they have gone out of their way to help the BCCI by giving its players to the BCCI, even at the cost of the international tours. And delaying the departure of the Sri Lankan players to going to England for their own tours, I felt that, you know, in the past we have done it to protect the integrity of the boards and the revenue of the boards. But now we are going and actually moving forward and actually doing injustice to the game of cricket. And that's the reason I've come out today and given what the reasons are.
Right, Mr. Modi, as far as the Sri Lankan Premier League is concerned, your name was mentioned by the BCCI that apparently the Singapore-based company that was running the operations of the SLPL had some links or the other to you. You have, of course, vehemently denied that. But why do you think the BCCI is naming you? They could have put forward any other reason.
I mean, as far as the BCCI is concerned and finding and saying that I have something to do with Somerset, it's somebody's wild imagination. BCCI has always come up with allegations which they haven't been able to prove till now. And it's always according to media sources or an inside source in BCCI. Why doesn't somebody come up there and say it blankly what it is? I come forward and say it right there and there on camera. Why does it have to be an inside source? Why don't they say what they have? For last 1 year, they have alleged I have done X, Y, Z. But for the last 1 year, they haven't given one concrete concrete document to show that my involvement is in anything at all. It is just flying a bogey up there and then going out there and trying to hope that, you know, they're going to find something. At the end of the day, there must be something to find. But in the meantime, their livelihoods of people being affected, players are being affected, and now the game of cricket is being affected on a whole. And that's the I really don't understand what the reason is. Do they think that they can get away by trying to take another member's rights to do what they want and the other member's not going to react? I think they are sitting in a place where they're sitting by themselves and they really don't see beyond the shadow.
Meanwhile, the BCCI President Shashank Manohar has reacted to Lalit Modi's accusations in a typical couldn't-care-less attitude. He said, and I quote, "I don't want to react at all to Mr. Modi. He seems to fascinate the media, but he does not fascinate me." Now, the question many would like to ask the recluse, Mr. Manohar, what in the world does fascinate you, sir? Well, moving on and staying with the BCCI. The BCCI for now seems to have made up its mind not to release players for the Sri Lanka Premier League. But guess what? The bosses are completely fine with two teams from that competition playing the qualifiers of the Champions League T20. Now, meanwhile, the Lankan bosses are trooping down to India to discuss the situation with Manohar and company. They are very clear about the official status of the tournament, and even other boards have assured to release their players. Well, that's a wrap on the sports update so far on this bulletin. It's back to you, Evelyn.
Thanks very much indeed, Natasha. Now, today is World Music Day, and Chennai City not only boasts of the Super Kings, but also of the Super Crooners. Over to Grammy awardee Tanvi Shah, the main vocalist of the song that rocked the nation, Jai Ho.
Hi everyone, here's wishing all of you a very happy World Music Day. The next song I'm going to perform is from the northeastern part of Brazil, and it's a genre called Embolada Samba, and I hope you enjoy it.
Samba de roda, com a preta benegita. No tempo que Rio Vermelho tinha peixe mariquita, e o terreiro caça branca batia na barranquia. Candiwa de meninos enchi de cana moía. Quando o terno do Origofi rezava na soledade, e no lar dos aflitos tinha samba de verdade. Vi mamãe na areia, vi mamãe na areia. Eu vi mamãe nas conchinhas do mar, vi mamãe na areia. Vi mamãe na areia, vi mamãe na areia, vi mamãe na areia. Eu vi mamãe nas conchinhas do mar, vi mamãe na areia. Vi mamãe na areia. Aprendi samba de roda com mãe preta benegita. No tempo que Rio Vermelho tinha peixe mariquita, e o terreiro caça branca batia na barranquia. Condigo a de meninos enchi de cana moía. Quando o terno do Origofi rezava na soledade, e no largo dos aflitos tinha samba de verdade.